James chapter 2 verse 10 says these words: fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison, that you may be tried, and ye shall have tribulation 10 days. Be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life. Will you turn with me now to James, chapter 1 and verse 2, 3 and 4. James, chapter 1, verses 2, 3 and 4. The scripture says, my brethren, count it all joy when ye fall into diverse temptations, knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. But let patience have her perfect work, that ye may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. All right, my brothers and sisters, from those scriptures today, I'd like to share with you this thought: never quit. Look at somebody and say, never quit. Touch somebody else and say, he said, never, never, never quit. In the book of Revelation, my brothers and sisters, we hear the Apostle John as he, she writes to the church at Smyrna. Smyrna. He said to that church, and I want you to listen to me because I need for you to open your Bibles and follow me. I need for you to look at the text. He said, fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. To me, he's saying, there's something coming. You're not in it yet, but it's coming, based on the language, thou shalt suffer. He didn't say you were suffering. He said thou shalt suffer. This is for all of y'all, amen, who perhaps don't believe because you so say, you don't have to go through nothing. I'll bust your bubble today. And that's why I have came here to tell you never quit. Because when the fires of hell hit your house, you better already have a dance. And so today is a good day to get up and practice one. Amen. You understand what I'm saying? Hallelujah. Practice a dance. Get you a song. Get you a scripture. Get ready, because when the enemy attacks, you got to be ready. He went on to say, behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison, that you may be tried. He's going to cause you some trouble. He's going to cause you some trouble. He's going to try your faith. He's going to try your faith. He's going to try your faith. And ye shall have tribulation 10 days. Somebody said, your tribulation is not going to last for long, 10 days. He put a front end and a back end on it. They used to say, trouble don't last always. There is an end. I should say there's a beginning and an end to everything. So if you're going through something today, amen, wave your hand and tell the Lord, thank you for the end of the day. Because the day is coming. He that will come, and touch somebody and say, never quit. Hallelujah. He said, be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life. Man, this is a prophetic message, if you will, to the angel of that church. Now, some have said that Bishop Polycarp, you may have never heard that name before, Bishop Polycarp, they say, was the pastor of that church, and that letter was written to him. He was alive during the time of John. He was a second century Christian bishop of that church. And according to the martyrdom of Polycarp, he died a martyr. Amen. The scripture became true in his life. He was bound and burned at the stake. Died like some other apostles. And the story says because the fire wouldn't touch him, they had to stab him to death. And he just laid there and took it. And there was a man that had Jesus in his soul. And he could see something. He could see like some others. Amen. It was a Stephen that said, Father, forgive them. But they knew not what they do. Amen. Sometime you just got to bend and give in to tribulation and trials and give God the glory. Doesn't always mean that you're going to die literally, but you are dying figuratively. Amen. You become more than what you are right now because of what you've been through. Hello, somebody. Oh, some of y'all are going to be powerhouses because of what you got to go through. I'm praying that nobody will back up and give in, because that just means you're going to have to start all over again. Hello, somebody. Because God has a mission and a will for your life. Don't forget what Jeremiah said. He said, I know the plans I have for you. Man, but if you have read that whole chapter, you'll find out God is saying you got to go through. Amen, because I know the plans I have. I'm going to bring you out of this, Kiki. You won't have to stay where you're at forever. Amen. Just got to endure. Now go back over yonder where you come from and tell them people you just got to hang until the Lord come. Yeah, hello. Go back over yonder and tell them, say, Bishop said hang. They get it. Tell them hang. Man, amen. And you got to learn how to hang with style. Don't hang pole mouthing. Hang and give God the glory. Man, so look at somebody and say, never quit. Man. He said here again, I remind you that the text, this Revelation text, is written in the future tense. So that encourages me, amen, to be prepared for what's coming. It's a sign of ignorance if you sit around and don't prepare, hallelujah, for Satan. Amen. One or both of them, one being God or Satan, is going to show up before the end of the day. Amen. If God don't get here before the end of this day, Satan going to show up. Oh, y'all don't hear what I'm saying. And he may show up before you get out of church today. Amen. That's why you got to be prepared for whatever happens. Because there's somebody whose nerve you've already got on. And they got a message for you. Amen. But whatever they say, never quit. Amen. James, my brothers and sisters, can I read that text to you? Address himself to future tribulations of our faith also. Notice what James said. Can you go back to that text? James chapter 1, verse 2. And let's just take a look at it very slowly here. Amen. He said, my brethren, count it all joy. First of all, you can't be his brother except you've been baptized in Jesus' name and filled with the Holy Ghost. That phrase, brethren, my sister, implies one that comes from the same womb. You can't say, amen, you my brother from another mother. No, we all got the same mama. Amen, it's called the church. We've all been born from the church. We've all been born by blood and water. There are no dry births up in here. Look at somebody saying, no dry births up in here. Amen. Everybody born by blood and water. Okay, you'll catch up onto that one of my days. But James said, my brother, count it all joy when you fall into the divers temptation. And then he said, look at verse 3. Look at verse 3. Look at verse 3. Look at verse 3. Verse 3 says what? Knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. I don't necessarily like that verse, but it's there. I can't do nothing about it. Hallelujah. Got to leave it in there. Hallelujah. But let patience have a perfect work. That's that verse over in Romans chapter 5. It says tribulation, work, patience. I don't like that verse either. Anybody in here like tribulation so you can have some patience? I need some patience, but I don't want to go through to get it. Amen. Why don't you just give it to me, Lord, and let it be done? But that's not the way God works it. Hello, somebody. Amen. God works it so that, amen, you got to go through something to get something. Hello, somebody. You had to go through something to get into this world, and you're going to have to go through something to get out of this world. You can't even die easily. It's a hard thing to die. Hello, somebody. You can't even die peacefully. Hello. It your body talks to you. Everything just, Lord have mercy. That's why you got to be saved. The only way to live, amen, is to get saved, get born again, so you come out of trouble, amen. And then when you die, amen, you the Lord can slip you right by death. He can cover you, and death can't get his hands on you. Hello? Now, he might touch your body, but he can't touch you. And please get an understanding with that. He might touch your body, but he can't touch you. Amen. And while he's telling you and talking to you, you can look at him and say, I ain't going to quit. Amen. What he wants you to do is stop giving God the glory. And he wants you to stop giving God a praise and a testimony. Brother Lane, he don't ever want to see you run down that aisle again. Not one more time. He don't ever want to see you stand up and dance. He don't ever want to see that again, ever. Hello, somebody. But when you stand up and give God the glory and give God the praise, I believe you give the devil a black eye. Amen. Look at somebody and say, the bishop said, never quit. Let's take a deeper look, if you will, at that word patience, that word that I have a problem with, because the word patience means cheerful or hopeful endurance, constancy, enduring patience, continuance, amen, or perseverance. Perseverance, there's a good word, to persevere. Perseverance, my brothers and sisters, it means steady persistence in adhering to a course of action, a belief, or a purpose, or steadfastness. Amen. To be steadfast, no matter what's going on. Amen. I'm not going to break, bend, or spindle. For those of y'all that used to deal with the data processing things, used to get those cards in the mail and tell you don't bend them, amen, whatever, because they had to process them again. Hallelujah. I'm telling you the same thing. Don't break, bend, or spindle. Hello, somebody. I don't care what the devil does. I don't care what he says. Don't break. Don't bend. Amen. You can lean. Hallelujah. Amen. You got to, and sometimes you got to get a great lean on. You know what I mean? Amen. The devil got, sometimes, oh yeah, the winds of tribulation can blow so hard, it'll make you lean. Hello. Hallelujah. You can lean like this, but you got to let the devil know, when your breath stops stinking and you stop blowing on me, I'm going to stand up again and I'm going to get. Oh, y'all ain't with. I see your hand. I see your hand back there. Amen. You just can't quit. You just can't. And your message coming off of your soul has got to be one that I will not quit. Now, I heard my pastor talk to us about faith. And I if pastor don't mind, I'm going to run my little definition through. Amen. I'm not trying to counteract his, because I think our definitions are the same. But your faith has got to be strong so that you don't quit. Because the devil is challenging your faith. Did God really say he's going to come back and get you? But the book said, he that will come shall come. It didn't say when he was going to come, but he said he shall come. And then when he said, when I come, will I find you faithful? Will you be there giving me the glory? Will you be there giving me the praise? Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? One thing I know about the devil, amen, you can't turn him off, baby. Amen. You may make him go away, but one thing about that rascal, he's going to come back. But when he come back, you got to make sure he's got the same message. You're back. I see. Yes. Well, let me tell you something. I got the same message. I got the same song. And you're going to have to go get the same authority. Hallelujah. Because God knows how much I can bear. He won't let you put more on me than I can bear. I already know that. Oh, y'all, you're not walking with me today. So faith defined means knowledge, which means understanding the principles of God. I know what God will and won't do. I already know it. I already know that God said he would that no man should perish, but that all should come to repentance. Did y'all hear that word? Or you can turn me down a little bit if you like. Amen. He said, I would that no man should perish, but that all should come to repentance. That means, amen, I don't care what you're going through. As long as you demonstrate repentance in front of me, hallelujah, I'm going to bring you through. Hello, somebody. You see, God didn't set us off into this world to be defeated. I don't know about you. Maybe you got a defeated God, but my God does not allow me to be defeated. Sometimes victory takes a while to get here. But that's a test of my patience. That's a test of my faith. That's a test of my endurance. That's a test of my persistence. But I know what God has said. Amen. The next part of that definition is belief. I got to believe the principles of God. I know what they are, and I got to believe them. And the pastor uses a word called assent. He said, you must give assent to, amen, what you know and what you believe. That is to concur, to agree, or to act on the principles of God that you know and believe. You got to act on what you know and what you believe. Mm-hmm. And so if the Lord says to you, amen, I'll keep you till the hoary hairs, you got to stay there till you get the hoary hairs. That really means white hair. Now, I'm doing a good job, I think, so far. Hallelujah. I still got some more black up there. I think I do anyway. Hallelujah. And yeah, don't laugh at me because, at least I got some, y'all. All right, back to it. Lord have mercy. But God said he'll keep you to the hoary hairs. Hello, somebody. And I almost said something, but Sister Brenda, get on me if I say that. But never quit. Look at somebody saying, never quit. Never quit. James doesn't say if trouble comes your way, but James says whenever it does. He assumes that we'll have troubles and that it's impossible or that it is possible to profit from them. The point is not to pretend to be happy, because some folk, hallelujah, like that, pretend like everything's all fine. Is that not, Pastor? Sometimes people want to act that everything is hooky-hooky and kissy-kissy. Well, that's a lie from the pit, because sometimes I don't feel like it. Sometimes I ain't feeling God in it. Sometimes my body don't feel good. Sometimes I don't like you. Sometimes I know you don't like me. And sometimes I don't care what you don't like. Hello, somebody. Man, that don't mean I'm not saved. That just means I'm going through some emotions right now. Amen. But what you got to do is pray for me and wait for me to come back, because I will be back. Hello, somebody. Look at somebody and say, he said he's going to come back. So you know, stop acting like folk are going to got all unsaved because they ain't feeling you today. Hello. Hallelujah. Amen. You don't feel everybody every day either. There's somebody in here already. You done already kicked them to the curb. If God could play all our thoughts up on the wall, Lord have mercy, most of us had to walk out of here with our heads down. But thanks be unto God, he keeps those things secret. Amen. So there's not a fight up in here. Oh, I know I'm right. The point is not to pretend to be happy when we face pain, but to have a positive outlook. I know some folk up in here. Amen. The doctor said you got this. And you run around telling folk, I don't care what the doctor say. I know I ain't got it. Well, I'll tell you what. Amen. When that pain hits you, you're going to confess. You got it. Hallelujah. You'll confess you got it. Amen. And so when you're praying to God, when you're talking to God, God wants you to tell the truth. Please let me help you. You know, if you still got teeth in your mouth and you ever had a toothache, you can't run around and tell folks, I don't have a toothache. That tooth is killing you, and you know it's killing you. Amen. And God's waiting on you to say, I got it, so he can deliver you from it. Hello, somebody. Man, what God wants you to do is never quit about what you're going through, amen, and give God the glory, amen, and ask, because the book says you have not because you ask not. You're not listening to me right now, amen. But when you confess before God, amen, what the truth of the matter is, see, you can lie to me all day long. It don't mean nothing. Now, I can't deliver you from stuff. But when you go to God and say, Lord, I got a toothache. And God touch your body, now something got to happen, because God has touched you. Hallelujah. He expects, amen, a praise. He expects some worship out of you. Yeah, it's a simple thing. I know you done stood up about that toothache 15 times and somebody in the back going, I sure wish you'd sit down and shut up. How many times we got to hear you tell us about how God done deliver you? Well, listen to me, baby. They weren't the one with the toothache. But when God delivers you, don't let nobody make you sit down. Don't let nobody make you stop. Don't let nobody tell you to shut up. Lord, if you tell me to shut up, I'm getting worse. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. I came today to just tell you, never quit. Sometimes we become angry and frustrated with God because things don't work out the way we think they should or as quickly as we would like. Anybody here know what I'm talking about? You've been talking to God a long time and seems like ain't nothing happening. Anybody ever prayed them prayers? I heard you this morning. It seemed like sometimes they just hit the ceiling. They ain't going nowhere. Even your spouse don't want to hear you no more. They thinking in their mind, I wish you would just put the shut with the up. Lord have mercy. But God is saying, come on, bring it. Come on, bring it. He's waiting on your soul to get that request just right. Y'all hear what I'm saying? God is waiting on that sanctifying principle to work through you, because this one thing I know, let me give you a secret right now. The reason why God can deliver so miraculously and so magnificently in a number of us is because at the time that you pray, amen, you get the flesh out of you. Can I put it another way? Can I go down on Pontiac and Hannah? When God get the hell out of you, you will pray, amen, without any flesh in you at all. Amen. Matter of fact, you'll stop praying about your difficulty and be going to praying about everybody else's difficulty. You'll say to God, Lord, if it be thine will, let this cup pass. But nevertheless, thine will be done. If there's only one healing left, give it to Brother Carter. Because God, I know you got my back. I know that when you come, you're going to say, well done. And I'm here, oh God, I'm going to endure to the end. This is a recall to my mind. Therefore have I hope. It is of the Lord's mercies. I shall not be consumed. His compassion. Okay. Please sit down. Let me. Please, y'all. You got to know this thing. You got to know what God has said. Amen. I don't care how the devil works it. And you know, if you ever had pain in your life, and it don't always have to be sick pain. It's when a friend hurt you. When a friend deserts you. Somebody you invested in. You've invested time in. Do you know what I'm talking about? And they hurt you by deserting you. You stood with them many times. In the book of Ephesians, chapter 4, somewhere around verse 2. It talks about how we need to stand with one another, being long-suffering. Amen. Being long-suffering. Endeavoring to keep the unity of the faith. Amen. Standing with each other. Amen. You're not the guilty one. They're the guilty ones. But God is telling you to stand with them. When everybody else want to walk off and leave them, you won't leave them. You stand with them. Everybody's saying how guilty they are. And if you stand with them, you're going to look guilty. Y'all hear what I'm saying? But you're in your spirit. The Lord is saying, stand with them anyhow. Stand till I come and deliver. Stand until, you understand what I'm saying? And everybody's saying, well, Brother Carter, you're standing with the bishop. You must be guilty of the same thing. But see, God has said in your spirit, don't quit. Even when the bishop quit, amen, God will tell you, go out there and get him. Go out there and get him. Bring him up in here and pray for him again. tear with him again, get out on the floor, roll on the floor with him again. Y'all ain't hearing what I'm saying. Sometimes that's what you got to do for each other. That's what God sent you to do. Hallelujah, somebody. But there's a crown of life waiting on you if you don't quit. Amen. You see, some of us think that what this life is all about is having a big house. Some of us think what this life is all about is having money. Some of us think all about what this life is all about is having a spouse. Some of y'all don't need to be married. I didn't bite my tongue on that one. Some of us don't need to be married. You talk to some of us folk that have been married a long time. The very epitome of sacrifice can be found in marriage. Some of y'all, before you get married, you better go to the pastor and ask him to teach you about what love is. You can take me up there now, Master, because I'm about to go there. You see, love ain't about what you look like. See, when I got married to you, you look like a Coca-Cola bottle. When I got married to you, you look like Mr. Atlas. All your Atlas now is on the floor. When I got married to you, you didn't have no lines in your face. I better go back up here. Thank you, Jesus. You see, you need to understand. The kind of love that God's talking about is not the kind of love that make that when they walk through the room, bells and whistles go off. The kind of love that God is talking about is the kind that when I see you and you have a need, I put my life down so I can meet your need. And this is not reciprocal, and this is not 50-50. Punch somebody and say, don't quit. You know how many times I've heard somebody say, well, when is it gonna be my time? When is it gonna be my turn? If you're gonna ask that question, don't say I do. I'm coming back out there with y'all again, so I ain't scared. I'm talking to you about never quit. You get married today and they look all beautiful and pretty, and you walk out to church and somebody T-bone you or they have a massive stroke. You just a few minutes ago said, for better, for worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health. Now they don't have no health. They all twisted up and don't look good. Even Mugly look good on them because they just ugly, but Mugly. Am I with you, Evangelist? Am I in this? I hope I'm in this thing. Now what you gonna do? Yeah, you know I'm right, right? Now what? Don't be looking in the book for a way out. Look at somebody and say, never quit. If there's only one piece of bread left in the house, your spouse gets it. Don't go there with me, Janelle. If you don't have your mind made up, that's how you're going to love, you shouldn't get married. See, the kind of love that most of us talk about is based on what you look like. They may be good looking now, but what if something devastating happens? I think I heard some message like getting old. Right? I used to be good looking. Well, you know. I'm trying to help some of y'all. But you can't quit. Hello, somebody. Sometimes these experiences that we have will burn pride out of us. Get you prepared for the coming of the Lord. The coming of the Lord is in all kinds of little incidental tests. Like I said before, when honey leaves you, can you still trust him? When especially you run around and told everybody the Lord told me to get married to him. Now, you see, we have to agree that God can tell you to get married to somebody, and he already know they're going to leave you. Uh-oh. All right. I got to play the lawyer. How many of y'all remember the text where the Lord was ministering and he said to the brethren, you all get on the ship, go to the other side. He went away praying. Now, how many of y'all believe that our God knows everything? He knows the end from the beginning. He already knew a storm was going to blow up. But he still said to the brethren, get on the ship, go to the other side. Hello, somebody. He did that so he could test their faith. Just when they thought they was going to drown, here comes Jesus. And he wasn't on a jet ski. He was walking on the water. He's walking with purpose. I got some brethren out on the ocean. So honey may not be with you always. But you're right. This sister married a man and he lived, what, 2 years maybe? Died. That can tear you up. Sister Julia died after 32 years. You were married to Brother Clinton how many years? 33 years. The longer you're with somebody, the worse it gets. Amen? But you can't quit. Does it shock y'all that me and Sister Brenda talk about it like that? It is what it is, y'all. Hello. We talk to our children like that. It is what it is. Hello. We're all looking for the coming of the Lord. What are you going to do? Never quit. When your money fails, don't quit. When your health fails, don't quit. If your mama or your daddy kick you out, don't quit. Hello? They repossess your car. Don't quit. If somebody says something hard and nasty to you in the church, you ought to stand up and go. You don't have to tell them what they said, just. I'm serious. Don't quit. Come to the house of the Lord to destroy your spirit. They may not know they are, but see, because some of us can't take nothing. First time you say something to somebody, they're mad with you, and they're mad with you, and then they won't tell you. They won't tell the person they're mad with. They go get on everybody else. I've been with y'all too long, but you can't quit. Hello, somebody. The Bible lets us know that we're going to suffer persecution. And I just came today to let you know that no matter what you're going through, you may be going through something right now, but you can't quit. Amen. You may be even dealing with a habit, and you're trying to get out of it, you're trying to get through it. I got a word of wisdom for you and a word of knowledge. The quickest way to kill a habit is to do some fasting. Because if you can fast and kill your need to eat, you can kill any other habit you got. Oh, y'all, I didn't get no amens on that one. If you can stop eating, you can stop anything. Hello, somebody. I didn't say stop drinking water. Because some of you stop drinking water, you may pass out. You want to stay awake. You need to feel hunger pains. And then you need to tell them hunger pains, I don't care what you feel like. I don't care what you're talking about. I don't care what you're saying. I'm not opening my mouth. I'm not taking in any food until the appointed time. Never quit.